Hi, my name's Alyssa and I'm Brightly's low waste lifestyle expert. If you're into sustainability, subscribe down below, become a change maker. But other than that, let's get started. So today we are unboxing this. This is the Everist waterless shampoo. So this is a 3x concentrated shampoo and we're gonna open it up. We're gonna talk about their sustainability features and we're gonna test it out. So I just got this. I have not tried it yet. Now this video is not a sponsored YouTube video by Everist, but we do have other ad placements with them on things like our Instagram and TikTok. So take that as you will. This is not an ad. This is my first time trying this out, but we are affiliated with them. Along with that, we do have a discount code and a link with them if you want to support us and get a discount if you think you're interested in something like this. I will leave that all in the description. So now that that's all out of the way, let's unbox. Okay, this is what the packaging looks like. Big blue circle, their logo, nothing too crazy, definitely all matte, all cardboard, all recyclable so far. So, gonna open her up. At the top, it says good, clean, fun for happy hair. And then it has their social channels and their hashtag. Okay, first thing in here is this little card. Now, what I will say about the packaging right away is that it's very thoughtful in terms of sustainability. And I say that because everything in this box so far that's paper or cardboard related is matte. It has a matte natural finish. There's no gloss on it. Now, by no means am I saying you're not a sustainable company if you use any kind of gloss on your cardboard or your paper. But you know, when you get glossy cardboard or paper and you're like, can I recycle this? I don't think that with this. I know I can recycle all this. So one side tells you a couple things. It tells you how to use it. It also tells you that they're part of 1% of the planet and that they're certified climate neutral. And then on the other side, it tells you that their formula is clean, plant-based, cruelty-free, preservative-free, sulfate-free, silicone-free, color-safe, and 3x concentrated. And then under here, it tells you how to dispose of everything in this package, which I really love. So their tube is made of aluminum. It says to unroll flat and place in the recycling bin without no need to clean, which I find interesting. Usually I clean it. I will probably cut my tube open and clean mine personally, but it says you don't have to. So I would maybe check with your city recycling, see what they think. And then the cap. So the cap is plastic, but what I like about what they do is it's the only thing in this entire package that you would kind of pick it up and be like, how do I dispose of this without putting it in a landfill? They take those back. So this cotton bag is actually what that's for. So once you collect some of those caps, and you can put them in here and you can send it back to Everist. And all you have to do is print the shipping label. So that's free. That's 100% free recycling program. You just fill up their little baggie, which I think, I mean, that's really awesome. I love when companies take responsibility fully for their packaging, including the little things. So they take those back and recycle and reuse those, which is great because it's also taking the stress off me, the consumer. When I buy your product, I want you to have thought out all of your packaging for me. You know, it shouldn't be the consumer's job to figure out how they're gonna dispose of everything. You know, the company has to take accountability somehow. So I think this bag method is a really neat way to do that. Plus it's kind of cute, like, who doesn't love a bag? And then for the boxes, it says to just place in your recycling bin, that they are carbon neutral and recyclable and printed on 100% recycled paper, which is really neat. So love this, really love the cap initiative they have. Another thing in terms of sustainability, when I received this package, it was packaged really tight. So there was no excess space. They didn't waste any paper, like shoving it in there to keep everything safe. It's all just the cardboard boxes and they all perfectly fit together. And they really thought that out so that they didn't have to supplement with more materials. So I really appreciate that. I really like that. So let's take a look at the packaging of their tubes. Again, matte cardboard finish, the same for both the shampoo and the conditioner. What I also like that they did was they labeled them 1 and 2. So the shampoo and conditioner part is actually in pretty small writing. So the fact that they labeled it 1 and 2 in terms of steps is actually super helpful. But we'll open up the shampoo. I'm pretty sure from what I saw on the website, they look about the same. Yep, yep, exactly what I thought. So I thought they had, oh, there it is. Okay, and in here, shake it out, you get the tube key. So on the back it says instructions, wet hair and hand, squeeze a large pea size amount onto palm and rub to activate. Work from root to tip for at least 30 seconds and wonder why no one thought of this earlier. Rinse well, adjust dose is needed for optimal lather. A large pea size amount is a very small amount compared to when I think of liquid, how much I pump. That's a very small amount, so that's pretty promising. So this is a 100 milliliter tube, and you might be thinking that's really small, but two things about it. They claim that this lasts as long as a full bottle of liquid shampoo. Also, it's super travel friendly because of the size, so you don't have to like make a travel size or buy a travel size because it's already like it's the size of my hand. It's pretty small, pretty good for a bag. And it says it lasts over 30 washes. So let's look at this. Here's the tube. Hopefully you can get a good look at it. So all aluminum, all recyclable. And here is that cap that you will put in the bag. So once I'm done, bag, cap, send back to them completely free. In fact, I think I'm even gonna keep their box around to do that with. Yeah, I'm really impressed by the cap thing for some reason. I really like when companies are able to do that for free for the consumer as well, that I don't have to pay to send their product back to them. All right, can we see that's the shampoo at the top right there? So as you can see, super thick. I mean, it feels like a cream, really. And this is the tube key. They said to use this right away to make sure you get every last drop. So I'm gonna do that. Just gonna slot it on so we can see, like, make sure it fits, make sure everything's good. I guess I put it, let me look at the picture. Yeah, I roll it forward. So I'm gonna really get it on there. Roll it. I just realized I did that below the camera. So you can probably squeeze the middle, but if you don't want to ruin this part and make it look kind of eh, you can probably just use the key to disperse the product. And yeah, it has that little number one on here too, so you don't have to go reading it. You can just search for the one and two on which one's your shampoo and conditioner. Okay, looking at the conditioner, it's the same thing. It's just got the number two on it, and it looks a little more liquidy actually. So now I'm gonna go and try these for a week, and I'll check back in with you of how I like it. All right, it has been 1 week exactly since I filmed that last video. So now I have some thoughts. Let me tell you. Okay, so I know during my unboxing, I was raving about the tube packaging, and I gotta rave about it again. Because here's the thing, the tube key, I wish everybody did. This is amazing to me. So I know I was freaking out about the cap take back program, which I still think is awesome, but the tube key, I never used anything with a tube key. I know David's toothpaste has a tube key, but I have never personally used anything like that. I love this. So let me show you why. This is really hard to squeeze out. I mean, it's not a liquid, it is a concentrate. So it's a little stiff in there. And as you can see, when you squeeze it like I was, like the bottle gets a little busted. And not busted as in it broke open, just busted with all these little dents in it. And it's just not very pleasing to the eye. So tip, don't even press on the bottle. If you just take this and start, you know, turning your tube key, it'll start to come out. So yes, if it feels a little stiff, hard to come out at first, use the key instead of pressing on the bottle. Second thing, I am totally amazed by how little I have to use. So they talk about on their website how the more hair you have, basically the bigger the size. Mine is just maybe a tiny bit bigger than a pea-sized amount. And it was amazing. Like, I couldn't believe that was all the product I need, because a week later, it looks like I haven't even touched these bottles, like in terms of how much product's in them. It's because you use so little, and they say this lasts as long as a full bottle of shampoo, but I would almost argue that this should last longer. I mean, I think about it almost like a shampoo bar, where they say shampoo bars will last 2 to 3 bottles of shampoo, but this, I feel like it will last more than one bottle. So really, I think they underrated themselves in terms of that. I think the amount of product used is a really good amount, which is great because these are $24. I don't know if I mentioned that last time, but they are $24, and I think you can get a set for about 46, I believe. I'll correct myself if I am wrong. So I think just how little product you use really makes the value go up, and you really feel like you get the bang for your buck. Now, let's talk about ease of application. I'm not gonna lie, the first two nights, I was like, how do I use this? Like, I feel like it wasn't lathering like I wanted it to. Like, I would put on my hand, I would add the water, and I'd, you know, and I felt like it would just disappear. So here's what I figured out. Completely wet your hair first. I mean, really wet it. Same thing with like a shampoo bar, how you want your hair to be super wet before you go in with it. Same thing with these, super wet hair. Then you have your hand wet too. So what I was doing wrong is I had my hand like fairly dry. I would squeeze some of the concentrate on there, and then I would like put it under the water and like add it. Don't do that. Instead, I just started with a wet hand, and sometimes it would completely lather up like normal. If I needed a little more water, that's when I would do a quick like hit under the water to make it lather up. But typically, if my hand was pretty wet, my hair was wet, I just did a quick dab, it would lather up like amazingly, like totally normal shampoo. So it might take one or two times to get it. That's not very long. I think that's a very small sacrifice to make, not really a big deal. After that, pretty good ease of use. All right, let's break it down in terms of effectiveness. So I'm gonna start off with the shampoo. First off, again, can we talk about how I heavily appreciate how they put the one and two on there? It just made it so easy in the shower because they do look pretty similar, you know, same color. So the fact that they have them numbered, it's just so easy to grab. So I am not a hair care expert, but I just judge shampoo based on how clean it makes my hair feel because I do have an oily scalp. I got thin hair, I gotta wash my hair pretty often. So I just judge it in terms of, does my hair feel any kind of grease afterwards? Is there any kind of residue? Because my hair is so thin, if there's any residue, any leftover, I feel it immediately. And I felt nothing. And I'm gonna be honest, even the first two times where I said I was having trouble getting it lathered, I thought it just didn't have the lathering effect because it still was cleaning my hair pretty effectively. But then after getting used to it, I realized it cleans effectively and it has a great satisfying lather. And obviously a lather is not a necessity, but it is really nice in terms of experience and application. So I rinsed this out like normal. I feel like it wasn't like a shampoo bar where I really had to like work to rinse it out. I felt like it was like a liquid in terms as it was in, quick rinse, it was out. So I didn't get any buildup, any residue all week, nor do I expect to in the future because it is just like a liquid. I mean, the second it lathers up in your hair, it is just like a liquid. You wouldn't even know that it's like a paste. So the shampoo, love it. Now let's talk conditioner. So the conditioner, same thing. I actually use such a tiny, tiny amount of the conditioner because I only condition the bottom ends of my hair. I do not condition all the way up to the root. Some people do, some people don't, depends on you. But I use an astronomically small amount. I mean, literally pea-sized, maybe even smaller. Lather it up and it covers all of my ends. Granted, my hair isn't the longest in the world. It goes a little bit past my shoulders, maybe an inch down. So keep that in mind. If you have super long hair, obviously you will use more than me. Or if you have short hair, you will use even less. There's a dog barking. I hope you didn't hear that. I didn't even realize it was barking. That's the neighbor's dog. So say hi to Buddy if you hear him. But in terms of effectiveness, I am not too picky with conditioner. So keep that in mind because my hair is so fine. It worked really well for me. I mean, I really have no complaints in terms of effectiveness. My hair felt nourished. I didn't get a lot of static afterwards. I mean, felt pretty good. So in terms of effectiveness, big, big win. And in terms of ease of use, win after you get it down. So there will be a learning curve most likely, or at least there was for me. But after that, it's pretty easy. It kind of seems like second nature already after a week. So I really can't complain. I'm really satisfied with it actually. Again, this video is not sponsored, but if you're interested in trying it out for yourself, I'll leave the link in the discount code below. Okay, and to give you a reference, like I said, I have oily scalp. I do have colored blonde highlights in my hair. I have thin hair and my hair is straight. So I liked it. That's the rundown of my hair. But I'm looking at their website, and if you go there, they have some reviews and they show you kind of like the hair texture and color of those reviews. So if you want to hear it from other people, if you have curly hair, if you have dyed hair and you want to know, go there and check out those reviews. But it seems like a pretty universal formula. They even say only formulated with the ingredients your hair needs, which I really appreciate. I think that's a really cool concept. So that is it for this video. I hope you guys learned some things. I hope you guys found this interesting. If you guys, again, are interested in trying these concentrates, check the description and tell me your experience. Have you tried Everist? Have you tried a concentrate? What do you think of shampoo bars, of bulk liquid shampoo? What's your favorite? But yeah, let's start a conversation about shampoo and help each other out to see what each other likes. But anyways, I encourage you to subscribe to our channel and drop a like on this video, and I'll see you next time.